ॐ सहना भवतु, सहनौ भुनक्तु, सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ शुक्लाम्बरधरं विष्णुम् शशिवर्णैचतुर्भुजम् प्रसन्नवदनं ध्यायेत् सर्वविघ्नोपशान्तये सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यम् वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा येनाक्षरः समां नायम् अधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृत्स्नौ व्याकरणं प्रोक्तम् तस्मै पाणिनये नमः अकूह विसर्जनीयानां कण्ठः इचूयशानां तालु ऋटुरषाणां मूर्धा ऋतुलसानां दन्त्याः उपु उपद्मानीयानाम् औष्ठौ न्यमगणनानां नासिकां च ए दैतौ कण्ठतालु ओदौ तौ कण्ठोष्ठम् वकारस्य दन्तोष्ठम् जिह्वामूलीयस्य जिह्वामूलम् नासिका अनुस्वारस्य मुकेश भाई
रामः रामो रामः रामं रामो रामान् रामेण रामाभ्यां रामेः रामाय रामाभ्यां रामेभ्यः रामात् रामाभ्यां रामेभ्यः रामस्य रामयोः रामाणां रामे रामयोः रामेषु राम रामौ रामाः।
शर्मिला जी फलम
फलं फले फलं फलं फले फलं फलेन फलाभ्यां फलेः फलाय फलाभ्यां फलेभ्यः फला फलाभ्यां फलेभ्यः फलस्य फलयोः फलानां फले फलयोः फलेषु फल फले फलानि।
तीतहांति ओके पूजा इज देयर आई डोंट नो तीतहांति सीतहथ मी वहमह लुएन अजिया
same one Swamiji.
Yeah, with suppose gama, with gama you can do gachha means gachhati
gachhati gachhatah gachhanti gachhasi gachhatah gachhath gachhami gachhavah gachhamah
translation you know everybody knows no tita
yes.
Okay So today we are in fourth lesson and we have seen total we have to study 1, 4, 6, 10 conjugation. First conjugation, fourth conjugation, sixth and tenth. So today we will see fourth. We have completed first one. The fourth conjugation, the name is divadi. So there is a one verb. Diva, to shine. So this fourth conjugation starts from diva. Adi means it starts from diva. So diva is a verb. In Sanskritum, it's called dhatu. So fourth conjugation, present tense, active voice, it's called kartari prayoga. So what we are seeing is kartari prayoga. So formation of the base. First we receive, then I will show you. The radical vowel does not take guna. The first condition of fourth conjugation, ya is added to the root. The letter a is added before the terminations, that a becomes a before termination beginning with ma and va. And last one is that a is dropped before termination beginning with akara. So let's start. That's why I have shown you this. Only this much. So here, suppose there is a div, select, retake div. We have to add Yeah. And then we have to add all terminations. I am just writing the. So div plus ya becomes divya. Then we have to add one by one all termination. Ti, taha, anti. So divyati, divyataha, divyanti. So that rule, this akara, one akara is dropped here. Otherwise, we come divyanti. You know there is a dirgha sandhi rule. So there is a no dirgha sandhi. This one a is dropped. So this a is dropped becomes divyanti. Same, divyasi, divyataha, divyatha. Now, in the front of ma and va, divya becomes divya, becomes a. So divyami, divyavaha, divyamaha. So divyasi, he shines, divyataha, they too shine, divyanti, they shine. Divyasi, you shine, divyataha, you too shine, divyatha, you all shine. Divyami, I shine, divyavaha, we too shine. Divya Maha, we all shine. So there is a no any guna, nothing. Simply ya is added to direct dhatu, means direct verb. Like in first conjugation, we have seen we have to add akara. This akara causes guna of last vowel, radical vowel. Or this akara even causes guna of short penultimate vowel. There is a no such thing. Simply ya is added. So suppose there is another, is a push. Everybody knows, one who is a yoga teacher, one name of son is Pushan. Push is a one verb. The meaning is to nourish. That's why the name of son is Pushan. Because of the presence of son, we all are nourished. That's why he is a Pushan. So this is also in fourth conjugation. So it's become push. Plus ya become push ya. Who will do now?
Yeah, I will do. Pushyati, pushyatah, pushyanti. Pushyasi, pushyataha, pushyatha, pushyami, pushyavaha, pushyamaha.
Disha, no? Push. Dishakara, we have to pronounce it as sha. Pushya.
Yeah, in the...
Yeah, please try. Pushya.
Pushyami.
Yeah.
Pushyamaha, pushyamaha.
So there are... three shakara, no? One is Shankarasha. Another is Sa.
Chavarga Sa. Cha, cha, sha, yeah.
And another is Sha. So all pronunciation in Gujarati, you know, even myself also did mistake. But actually, Sha, 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 Sa, sha. While pronouncing, your tongue should touch palate. It becomes sha. sha. Then sha, Shankara sha. At that time, our tongue should touch on the top of the old dent of dantyas. Sha and sa. Sha, sha, sa. Okay?
Okay.
Now you try, yeah, please.
Yeah.
So that they have done. So radical vowel does not take guna. Simply, ya is added to the root. Letter a is added before termination. Ma and va becomes pushyami. And a is dropped before termination, beginning with a. Here, anti. The termination are the same as those of the first conjugation, means titahanti, sitahatha, mimahavaha. It remains same. So termination means that what you know. Titahanti, ti, here si, in me. You can add everything. It's called total 9. Now they have given here the application, push to nourish, formation of the base, no guna of the radical vowel. So it is a push. Ya is added to the root, so it becomes pushya. So this is half what I have written. So push, the shakar is also half. Ya is also half. So it's become pushya. In my thinking, this is no half yakara, it should be full yakara. Half yakara. It should be ya only. Because we never said pushyati. The full yakara is there. This is the wrong. So here, it is not half yakara. It should be full yakara. So before termination, beginning with half ma and va is become ushya, and before the termination, beginning with it becomes a become ushya. Yes.
Can we say that the anga for this root is
This pushya, this pushya, you know, verbal base. First time we have seen, this is called verbal base or anga. Anga or
this. So, we also saw the anga in Vyadi Bhav. Isn't that anga also?
So, in same, in first conjugation, we have seen Bhu is a dhatu. We have to add akara. But this akara causes guna of ukara, radical vowel. So, Bhu becomes Bho. We should know what is the guna letters of U. Is a O, that's why Bo. Then O is still there. You know Ayav Sandhi, so it becomes Bo. O and A, it becomes Bo. Va. So half Bo becomes full Bo. With this akara and half vakara joins this. This is bhava, is a verbal base. Then bhavami, bhavavaha. So fourth conjugation is very easy. So I would like to show one thing here. Here Raman. Now what we are seeing here Raman. But here Ramena. Actually Nakara is like here Falena. Same way here also it should be Ramena. Now is full, sorry. But they have written Hanakara. So how this Nakara becomes Hanakara? Every time the na should be added, Falena. But why here Ramena? Here Falani. Now they will explain. There is a one more Shabda is called Sharira. Sharira is also neuter. We can decline like Fala Shabda, but Shariram, Sharire, here it will come. Sharirani. So why Nakara comes? Why Nakara doesn't come? So what's the rule behind this? This will explain now. Okay. Same way here now. So now they are explaining why na becomes na. Where na converts into nakara in the presence of whom? It being explained now in this lesson. They have given here the nominative and the accusative plural of neuter nouns in a ending in ni means vanam, vane, and here vanani. In the some cases, however, we have to write ni, sharirani, instead of ni, like vanani, as in shariram, the meaning is body, become sharirani. The role to be applied in this and similar cases is the following. So why this na becomes na? So they have explained. It is a tricky, but it's good. So they have explained now. When in the same word, na is preceded by three things. Ru, raf, refa, and half shakar, means shanmukhasha. And these are followed by a vowel. Half na, ma, ya, or va, it is changed to na. The rule applies even when na is separated from the preceding R, ru, ra, and sha by several letters, provided those intervening the letters be a vowels, gutturals, labials, or half ya, half va, ha, and anuswara. Let's see. First is here they have given the example patrani, narena. Ramaya, Raman, actually Ramayana. So first is Patrani. So it should be written as a Patra, like Phalani, Patrani. Patra means Alif. But we have to write Ani. Why? So this nakara is preceded by this refa. Because we know patra means half the half ra. And this repha is followed by a vowel. So it's a A. Vowel. So na ma yava is changed to ya. So this na is changed to nakara. That's why this na convert into na. Same way narena. Suppose narena, actually narena is 3 by 1. So nara, nare actually is na. But this nakara also preceded by repha, and this repha followed by a means vowel. So that's why it is convert into na. Still, Ramayana, actually Ayanam. There is a one is called Ayanam. Ayanam is abode. Ayan. Abode of Rama is called Ramayana. So they have written Ramaya Ana. Ramaya and Na. Again, this Na is preceded by here repha. There are many letters in between, and this repha is followed by vowel. So this becomes anakara. Even in between this repha and nakara, this ma, naya, and if there, still it converts na into na. Let's see. Now they have given one more example. Pushyanti. Suppose, so it is, why Pushyanti na doesn't convert into nakara? Suppose Pushyanti, Pushya, so this nakara, why we are not writing nakara? So because this nakara is followed by tha. So they have written when in the same na is preceded by r, 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 because na is followed by tha and then ikara is there. Yeah. Let me write here. So here, push, anti. Here, na is followed by tha and then e comes. That's why nakara doesn't convert into nakara. Now tell me, if I ask, everybody knows now Rama Rupa, no? Rama, Rama, Ramaha. So 2 by 3 is Raman. And 3 by 1 is Ramena. So why here Nakara converts into Nakara, and why here Nakara doesn't convert into Nakara? Why? Can you give, anybody can give the answer? Why? So here the rule is, suppose when nakara, same word na is preceded by this, and this na is followed by a vowel. Here Raman, nakara is half, it is not followed by any vowel. That's why na remains as a na. Why in Ramena? Na, here, here is akara is there. Half nakara is followed by akara. That's why na converts into nakara, because in na, preceded by refa. Any question? Clear? Still they have explained Arjunena. Why not like Ramena? Here, why not Nakara? So they have given, because the intervening ja is neither vowel or a guttural, a labial, or nor ya, va, ha, or anuswara. Because Arjuna. 3 by 1 of Arjuna is Arjunena. This na is followed by a. So one condition is fulfilled. Now it is preceded by refa. Half ra is there. But this refa, here it is given, it is preceded by refa, is followed by a vowel. So here it is followed by ja directly. Then a is coming. So there, because the intervening ja is neither vowel. So here actually Arjun means half refa plus half ja and u. So because the intervening ja is neither vowel, so this jakara is neither vowel. A guttural, kakha gaga is not there, even labial means papa baba not there, even ya vaha or anuswara. That's why refa doesn't convert into nakara. So they have given one beautiful one line to remember this all. Is in order to remember the above rule and commit to memory the following line. So they have given Rushir Vanamayam Chatat Salesham. So where na convert into nakara, so Rushir. So when in the same word na is preceded by r or ru, sha and ra, so first condition is fulfilled. Rushir means this nakara should preceded by either r, dirgharu, sha and refa, followed by this refa or ru should be followed by a vowel. Or vakara, nakara, ma, and ya. So this refa should be followed by either vowel or va. They have not written. So I'm writing here vowel. Means any swara. Let me write vowel I have written. So this either r, shu and repa should be followed by swara or va, na, ma or ya. It is changed to na. But when it is not converted into nakara, So it's chatata. So they have given. They have written chatat salesham, provided the intervening letters be not the letters cha, chuvarga, cerebrus means ta, tatadadana, and ta means dental, tatadadana, or one of the letter salesham. So sa, la, and sha. Then only na converts into na. Understand or needs more clarification? Let me explain. Yeah, let me write. Suppose na convert into na when first condition na should followed swara. Where should I write? Can I write here? Yeah, here. So na should follow vowel first condition. Then na preceded by. R. Dirgaru, Refa, and Sha. In this also, should followed by vowel or vakara. Na, ma, or ya, then only na convert into na. First rule is na should be followed by vowel. So ramena means na plus a is followed by even sharirani, na followed by e. And this nakara should be preceded by either of these four. For the role of this r should means here ra and sha should followed by any vowel or va na, either va na makara or yakara. This is the second rule. So first rule, na should be followed by vowel, na should be preceded by rishi r, refa, or half shakara, shanmukha shakara. And this rishi r, refa, and sha. So here r is already vowel, so it is not discussing. But if refa and shakara is there, then this refa and half shakara should also followed by vowel. Otherwise, this refa shakara r should be followed by vakara, nakara, makara, and yakara. Then only it becomes converted into na into na. Yes, Pooja? Medha? Yeah.
Swaminiji, I think this nakara should be followed by vanamayam, no? Because the sentence is telling na is preceded by those and followed by these.
So even, there is a two nakara, even still. Suppose this is two nakara. So when they say rushir vanamayam, so meaning is this na, let me write here na, should be followed, is akara, but this nakara should be followed either this rushi, and this rushir should followed by this four. Yeah, and followed by either vakara, nakara, ma, and ya. It is
changing. No, Swaminiji, I think that intervening letters, those are the intervening letters are the ones that are followed by repa or the rashira, whatever has come.
No, actually what I said, the na is preceded by this, either of these three.
Meaning it comes first.
Yeah. So suppose Sharirani, suppose Sharirani. Even here, Arjuna. No, it's not. But this nakara is followed by vowel. This repa is followed by vowel. So there is a no problem. But here, even what the vanamayam means, this ru and followed by a vowel or vanamaya. Vanamayam means either vakara or nakara or makara or yakara. Then it is changes to anakara. This is positive. These two rules is for positive. And chatata salesham means they should not followed by this three. Chu varga, tu varga, tu varga, sa, la, sha, and even they have written sha only. So this is vanamaya they should follow. They have not yet written even vowel. So this r or sha should be followed by vowel, means repa and shakara, or they should follow this either this or four. Then only nakara changes. And what you would like to tell me now, tell me.
I was saying that the way they have written, it says na, nakara is preceded by rishir.
Yeah.
So meaning this rishir comes first, refa in sharirani or something, ra comes first.
Yeah.
Then after that, they have written and followed by, meaning they're still talking about nakara only, it seems. And
No. Actually,
nakara is followed by the vowel or vanamayam.
No, these are followed by vanamayam or vowel. Vowel they have not written because they are in some word, sometime repa come first and this nakara come last. But still in between, if there is a vanamaya is there, either va, still they changes into na. This is the meaning. If in between repa and nakara, if there is a vakara, nakara, makara or yakara, either of these four, still it converts into nakara. So this two is for positive. So it is converted into nakara, but this rushir should not follow this. Then it doesn't convert into na into na. If it follows va or na, ma and ya, then it becomes nakara. But if follows by chu, tu, tu and sa, la, sha, then it won't convert into nakara. So still you read, because it's very confusing, but...
Yeah, the sentence is not clear whether they are talking about followed by na or followed by rishir.
I will, right now I don't have that Panini Sutra, but I will share with you. Because in order to remember above rule, commit to memory, the following line, let me go first. Suppose... They have not given anything. Look, yeah, here it is written still. When in the same word, means repa may be somewhere else, in the same word, half nakara is preceded by these four. And these are followed by, because this is always as last only. So this r is followed by a vowel or this four, vanamayam, va, na mayam, then it is changes to nakara. Understand? But it should, this should not followed by this gutturals, labials, this guttural, labials, and what were they? Still one is there, yavaha. Then it doesn't convert into na tuna.
So that means after nakara, only vowel should be there and nothing else can be there.
Yeah. So that's why I was asking, no? So why?
At anti.
Yeah, Raman. So why Raman? Suppose Raman is a 2/3. This Raman, nakara is half. That's why it doesn't convert into nakara. because this nakara also should followed by some vowel. That's why it's remain nakara. Even what was there anti? What was there pushyanti? Suppose. I cannot able to write. Suppose this is pushyanti. So here even this na, then the and e. So na is not directly followed by e. In between this takara, that's why it doesn't pushyanti like that.
I thought because the is not part of vanamayam and that is why the root interplay.
So for nakara, rule is only one. This nakara should followed by vowel. If some conjunct consonant is there, there is a no in convert into nakara. Clear or not clear?
No, I got it. Vanamayam and Chatata both are conditions for Repha, whatever follows the Rishir
word. So for Shakara and this is Sha in Repha, condition is either vowel, they have not written. How they can write is, but this should followed either vowel or these four. Then only Na converts into Nakara, and this is when they never convert into natuna, then it is followed by either chu, tu, ta, sa, la, and sha. Then even they are in the same word, it doesn't convert into the. They have not given any more example, but we will find it out. And we can, if there are some chu, tu, tu is there, then it won't convert from natuna. Understand? Or not Luvena ji? Clear? Sharmila ji?
I'm also
not clear?
Also I'm clear. So both of them are confusing. I think we'll have to wait for some examples.
Yeah.
The way they've written the sentence is not very clear.
Sentence is not clear. So now convert into na. If we ask when, I will send you rule. So na should follow direct vowel. First rule. So half nakar should followed by vowel. First condition. Second condition is in same word. When half nakara comes at the end of the word, in same word, if this r repha and shanmukhasha hapsha is preceded by this nakara, and again rule is this repha and shakara. Why I'm telling this repha and shakara? Because there are already vowel. But this all should followed by either vowel here, either vowel or half na, half ma, and ya. So rule is applicable only for if they are followed by this. Followed means this repha, shakara, and this rr should be followed by va, na, ma, ya. Then only na converts into nakara. Except this, anything comes. So there are big things. Chu varga, tu varga, and tu varga. So palatal, cerebrus, and dentals. If they are in between Russia, then it doesn't convert. So second rule is applicable for this Repha and Shakara. So there is a Partha, no? One word is Partha. Let's say, what is the 3 by 1 of partha, anybody knows? Parthaya pratibodhitana. Then parthena, it would be parthena or parthena. Check. So pa, this ra, tha, a. And na. So the one condition is fulfilled. Na is followed by, but still this na preceded is repha. But in between, this is thakara. So ta tha. So it doesn't convert into anakara. So we all, if now check parthena is there or parthena is there. Always is a parthena. Because after repha, there is a thakara. If here it should be va na ma. If or over. Then only it converts into anakara. Any word you remember now still?
What about the anuswara rule? It should be there or not there?
Anuswara, yeah, they have not given.
They have given in the previous page.
Previous, they have written, but here example is not given, you know?
Yeah.
Or anuswara. They have not given, yeah. But still, let me take Krishna. Should I remove everything? Suppose we take one word, Krishna. So, Krishna. So, what is the third 3 by 1 instrumental case? Krishnena or Krishnena? What will come? Let's check.
No.
So let me start this Hafka and Rishiru. One is over. Because here two are there. Hapsha. This Na is Anuswara. Na. Is the A, no? So here is the A. Here, Na and A. So you check. One condition is Na should followed by vowel is fulfilled. Now Na should be preceded by R and Shu, both are there. So this Ru and this sha should be followed by vanamayam. But there is a no va, there is a no na, no, no, ma, and ya. But still we are writing Krishnena. Why? Because this ru is there. Rishi ru. That's why if you check Krishnena or Krishnena, do you have any book? Krishnena.
But na is a cerebral, the ta.
It should not be intervened by this. The sha should not be followed by na. Because they have written, provided intervened be not palatal, cerebrus. So cerebrus anakara is come. So Krishnena or Krishnena. Anybody knows? Anywhere have you seen is nakara is there or nakara is there? But I think nakara is be there because ru is there. Rishi ru. Kru, no? And this is no rule. It is followed by what? So it must be Krishnena. But I think Krishnena. I have to check.
I think that cerebral rule may apply. That varga.
Yeah. But it should not followed by, yeah. But still, there is a one Rishi Ru is there. No? And this Rishi Ru should followed by Vanamayam. So it is no Sha. That's why it should be Nakya. Yeah. This Ru should be followed by either Va, Na, Ma, or Ya. So when you check Na, it's written Krishnena, not Krishnena. Still any word? Let me check. Anybody knows? Any word? Guru word, no? Guru. Third case is Guru, na? Gurune. What is the third case? Guru, 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 Guru. Guru, Guru, Guruna, Guru Bhyam, Guru Bhyaha. Third by one is Guruna. It should be Nakara, Guruna. But why? So you have not seen Guru Shabda, Ukara ending, but it is a Gur, U, Na, and A. Guruna, Guru Bhyam, Guru Bhihi. So this nakara is followed by a, and here guru refa is followed by vowel. That's why guruna is there. So we keep on exploring, no, more words, then it will be more clear. Still a minute. Rule is, let me write again. Na becomes na. First rule, na should follow. Vowel. That's why Ramen, Raman, there is a no. And second rule, in same word. R, Dirgaru, Refa, and Shanmukhasha. Now, this four. Now, Nakara is not there, but this should, third rule is, they should follow either vowel or va na ma or ya, then only this na converts into na. This should not follow. What was there? Chu varga. Now you know chu.
Chatata solution.
Chatatu varga. Means cha means whole chu. Ta means whole two. Ta means whole two. And plus sa, then la, sal and shakara. Then in what convert into na tuna? Should not follow, and this should follow. Is it clear? This is the rule. Still won't understand. We will, next time we will see, but this is the rule. So it should, here we should write this na should be preceded by, here in same word, the na should preceded by this half na preceded by. Preceded by this four. Now this four should followed either vowel or these four, then only na becomes na. And this should not followed by this. Otherwise, it remains nakara only. There are many words, but right now doesn't come in our mind. But Partha, Krishna is the best example. Krishnena is there, not Krishna. Krishnena. We never seen Krishnena. Clear? Anything you would like to ask?
Go through it two times.
One, I will put some words. I will try to find out in Gita. Must be available. Then I will keep. Okay. Shall we do Purnamada? Om Purnamadav Purnamidam Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadha हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ओम